Coach Dave Island. Dave, thank you so much for joining us on what is just a gorgeous day here in downtown Detroit. What have you made so far from your Donald Ventura? Was able to get out of a bit of a jam there in the second.
Yeah, he's right where he needs to be. He's under control. He's repeating his delivery for the most part. He's giving him a couple different looks out of the stretch. He's slide-stepping, and he's slowing it down. So he's disrupting their timing a little bit. And most importantly, he's getting ahead in the count and expanding the zone.
Dave, what do you think his last start did for him? His first nine-inning complete game, very efficient with his pitches.
Well, I think it did a lot for him. I mean, it proved to himself and he can go out there and he can close a game out. I think it was very important that we sent him back out there in the ninth inning, even though he was at 96 pitches, I believe, when we sent him back out there for the ninth. But you know, you're not going to learn how to close games as a starting pitcher if you're never given the opportunity to do it. And he went out there and probably had his best inning. It was a 10-pitch inning, and some of the best stuff he had shown all day was in the ninth inning.
We saw him strike out Romine for round number two. As we're up to a pretty torrid start here, Martinez able to flag it down. Dave, the clock's ticking, so we'll get on with this. We saw him strike out Romine. Still had runners on base, and we could hear Salvador Perez on our microphone say, hey, you're not out of this yet. What does Salvador Perez mean to your pitching staff?
Yeah, I mean, Salvi's gotten really good at knowing how to manage each one of our pitchers and knowing what makes them tick, so to speak. So he knows when to go out and calm guys down and push the right button. So it's very vital with Salvi back there. And Drew Butera is the same way. So we're very fortunate to have two catchers that know how to handle these guys.
Hey, Dave, before the game, we spoke with Ned Yost about the grind of two consecutive deep seasons for the Royals. It's a good thing, obviously. Winning the American League pennant in 15 or 14 and then winning it all last year. Where have you seen it show up on the mound in terms of pitching that seventh month for your guys 2 years in a row? And I know it's not the same group, but the guys who have done it, what have you seen?
Yeah, well, I mean, you know, it's really hard to say. It's probably based on the individual. But, yeah, it does take its toll. I mean, these guys are human. I mean, for some of these guys, it's two short seasons in a row. But, you know, that's what you want. You know, we try to, you know, slow these guys down and not give them too much too soon in spring training. But you still have to come out and play 162 games just because, you know, you went to the World Series 2 years in a row. You don't get any breaks or any time off during the season. So you have to grind through it, and you have to be mentally strong as well as physically strong to do it.
Dave, we certainly appreciate your time. Thank you so much for jumping on with us here.
My pleasure.